Seniors for Grade 11 Science at Peters College, Kalambur, Nicobar Branch. Today I am going to discuss with you the human biological systems. On human biological systems, the circulatory system. On circulatory system, we will discuss today composition of blood, blood corpuscles or blood cells, characteristic features of blood cells, composition of blood plasma, functions of blood, longitudinal section of the human heart, systemic circulation, pulmonary circulation, or we call double circulation, heartbeat and the cardiac cycle, and finally the diseases and disorders associated with the human circulatory system. Before we discuss the human circulation, I would like to talk about the human heart. Human heart is a muscular organ. If you fold your fingers like this, it equals to the size of this. And it consists with four chambers, what we call four-chambered heart. Since we are mammalians, we have four chambers, two auricles and two ventricles. And also, apart from the four chambers, there are arteries, veins and capillaries to flow blood. What is blood? Blood is a thick red color liquid. And the functions are acting as a transportation medium for nutrients and transportation medium for waste material and to exchange gases or transporting different gases and also as a connective tissue. If you go through a centrifuge sample of blood, we can find different layer separation according to their densities. In the bottom, the higher denser particles will remain at the bottom, especially the blood cells, or we call blood corpuscles. At the bottom are RBCs, or we call red blood cells, or erythrocytes, and in the middle, WBCs, white blood cells, or we call them leukocytes, and also the platelets. And upper to it, as the topmost layer, blood plasma. If you go through the composition of them, percentages of them, plasma, pale yellow color fluid and percentage is 55%. Corpuscles, dark red color and even this part, percentage 45%. If you observe blood smear under the microscope, you will find all these cells. If we go through the classification, this is a blood sample. What are you going to observe under the microscope? Here, corpuscles and plasma. Corpuscles are cells. Here, WBCs, we can classify the corpuscles as WBCs, or white blood cells, RBCs, red blood cells, and platelets. Again, we can classify white blood cells as granulocytes and non-granulocytes, or we call granulocytes and agranulocytes. In granulocytes, there are tiny fragments or granules in the cytoplasm. But in non-granulocyte, examples are here, the cytoplasm is very clear. On the granulocyte, there are neutrophil, eosinophil and basophils. On the agranulocytes or non-granulocytes, lymphocytes and monocytes are examples. If we go through a diagrammatic representation of blood cells, these are the diagrams. Red blood cells, or we call erythrocytes. Later we will discuss more on these, the features of them. And here you can see WBCs, or we call them leukocytes. And the third one, platelets, or we call them as thrombocytes. Especially the function of RBCs or red blood cells, carry oxygen and exchange gases, carbon dioxide. WBC's phagocytosis function or engulfing bacteria, and platelets help in blood clotting, coagulation of blood. Here you can see the nature of WBC, the examples for WBC: neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil, lymphocytes and monocytes. These three are granulocytes. You can see the cytoplasm consists with tiny granules. These two are non-granulocytes. Now we will discuss about the features of RBCs or red blood corpuscles. If we take 1 cubic millimeter of blood, it has like 5 million of RBCs, and color is red, biconcave and disc-like structure, front view, disc-like structure, side view, biconcave. And place of origin is red bone marrow. Lifespan about 4 months. No nucleus, therefore it has the ability to squeeze through blood vessels. A large surface area, it is to absorb more oxygen. Hemoglobin is present, that's why the cells are in red color, and hemoglobin involves with carrying oxygen, and it combines with oxygen and form oxyhemoglobin. Then we will see the features of WBCs or white blood cells. It is larger than RBC and smaller in number, smaller in quantity. The function is engulfing bacteria, or we call phagocytosis function. And a nucleus is present, origin bone marrow, colorless. If we take 1 cubic millimeter of blood, it contains 4,000 to 11,000 WBCs. And if we consider the ratio of RBC to WBC, for 600 of RBC cells, there is only one white blood cell. That is the ratio between RBC and WBC. Then there are two types of WBCs. We have already discussed this: granulocytes and non-granulocytes, and here are the examples as well as the percentages of each type of cell. Then we will talk about the platelets, or we call thrombocytes. Actually, these are not cells, they are cell fragments and not a complete cell. Absence of nucleus, no nucleus. And 1 cubic millimeter of blood contains 150,000 to 400,000 of platelets. Origin in bone marrow. Lifespan 5 to 7 days. And involving with the coagulation of blood, blood clotting. Next, I will talk the content of blood plasma. Mainly what is there? Then protein, albumin, globulin, fibrinogen, as nutrients, monosaccharides, amino acid, fatty acid, glycerol and vitamins are there. As ions, sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium ions are there, chlorine and PO4-3, phosphate, sulfate and bicarbonate, it's CO3-. Then as nitrogenous byproducts, urea, uric acid and creatinine are there. As gases, carbon dioxide, oxygen and nitrogen are the gases. Then other than these, hormones, antibiotics and antigens are there. This is the content of blood plasma. Functions of blood: transportation of material as a transportation medium for nutrients, waste products and gases. Here digested and end products, respiratory gases, excretory byproducts, hormones, platelets, mineral ions and proteins. Transporting all these things, protect by body against the microbes. or we call engulfing bacteria or phagocytosis function, maintenance of chemicals in the body, and homeostasis. Human heart. Now we are going to talk about the human heart. Human heart is a muscular structure, and it has mainly four chambers, and the double circulation is a main feature of this system. Right. Now we will discuss about the main parts of the longitudinal section of heart. I told you there are four chambers in the heart: right auricle, right ventricle, left auricle, left ventricle. Accordingly, there are two auricles and two ventricles. So we call right atrium, right ventricle, left atrium, and left ventricle. Here you can see two blood vessels are coming. One is from top, the other one is from bottom. This is the superior vena cava. It brings blood from upper part of your body and it enters to the right atrium. Then inferior vena cava, it carries blood from lower part of the body and enters to the same chamber, right atrium. Then this is the right ventricle. In between the right atrium and the right ventricle, there is a valve. This valve is known as tricuspid valve, or we call atrioventricular valve, AV valve, or tricuspid valve. They are located, the tricuspid valve is located to downward, that is to the for the smooth flow of blood from right atrium to the right ventricle. After filling the right atrium, blood flows to the right ventricle. Right. Now this is the left atrium, left ventricle. And here you can see this is the pulmonary artery. Pulmonary means this enters to your lung. That's why we use the word pulmonary. Pulmonary artery contains blood with carbon dioxide. It starting from here, that means the blood which contains in the right ventricle enters to the pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery carry this blood to your right lung and the left lung. Look at the blue color vein branching into two from your left side as well as right side. They are entering to your lungs. That is for the purification of blood, to give out carbon dioxide and refresh your blood. Then from your lungs, from left and right, again you can see the branches, red color vessels here. They are entering to your left atrium. They are coming from your lungs to the left atrium with oxygenated blood. Then after filling the left atrium, there's another valve. Through this valve, it enters to the left ventricle. The valve here, AV valve, atrioventricular valve, or we call mitral valve or bicuspid valve. Mitral valve, bicuspid valve, or AV valve. After filling the left ventricle, the blood flows through this tube. It is the aorta. This is for the systemic circulation. It supplies blood to the whole body. Here you can find three branches. The middle one supplying blood to your head, and the either side of the middle one, the two vessels, they are supplying blood to the shoulder regions. Here I have given functions of each and every blood vessels. Now you can recall the longitudinal section of the human heart, or you can go through the diagram in your textbook. and find the functions of each and every vessel here. Superior vena cava brings blood from upper part of the body. Inferior vena cava brings blood from lower part of the body. These two are entering into the right atrium. Then tricuspid valves. This is located in between the right atrium and the right ventricle. We call it as the atrioventricular valve or AV valve. Then bicuspid or mitral valve, or we call AV valves. This is located between the left atria and the left ventricle. Then seminal valves. Seminal valves are located at the beginning of the aorta and the pulmonary artery. And again, there's a seminal valve at the pulmonary artery too. Then pulmonary artery contains blood with carbon dioxide, or we call deoxygenated blood. Then pulmonary artery enters your lungs as two branches for the purification. Blood is passing to your lungs for the purification, or to give out carbon dioxide gas. Then pulmonary vein enters to the left atrium with pure blood, blood with oxygen or with oxygenated blood. Pulmonary vein with oxygenated blood. Then this is the human circulation. You can find the red color for the blood with oxygen or oxygenated blood, blue color deoxygenated blood. Now here you can see artery that carries blood to your head region. I told you the aorta or the systemic artery branching into three, the middle one for the head region, the other two are for the shoulder regions. Then pulmonary vein, normally the veins are containing deoxygenated blood except the pulmonary vein. Only the pulmonary vein is a vein with oxygenated blood. All the other veins are with deoxygenated blood, blood with carbon dioxide. Here pulmonary vein has blood with oxygen. Now this you can see here, hepatic artery. Hepatic means liver. The artery which enters to your liver is the hepatic artery. Then artery that supplies blood to your intestine, the intestinal artery. This one is a renal artery. Renal artery carries blood to your kidney. And the systemic artery is moving down to send blood to the other parts of your body. Here you can see this side is containing blood with carbon dioxide, or we call deoxygenated blood. Okay. This is the renal vein leaving from your kidney. It enters to the inferior vena cava. Then this is the vein leaving from your liver. We call hepatic vein. Here you can see in the middle of the liver and the intestine there's a blood vessel. It has impurities as well as nutrients. It enters to your liver. Excess glucose is converted to glycogen and stored in your liver. And rest impurities will enter to the inferior vena cava. This is the inferior vena cava. All these are entering to the inferior vena cava with deoxygenated blood. Here we will see the function of each and every blood vessel. Hepatic vein leaves from the liver and enters to the inferior vena cava. Then hepatic portal vein from intestine to the liver. I told you it has nutrients. Excess glucose is converted to glycogen and stored them in your liver, and the other impurities will enter to the inferior vena cava. Renal vein leaves from your kidney with deoxygenated blood, and hepatic artery enters to the liver with oxygenated blood. Renal artery enters to your kidney with oxygenated blood. Then we will talk about the double circulation. Double circulation is the combination of pulmonary circulation and the systemic circulation. What is pulmonary circulation? Blood flows through your lungs. I told the meaning of the word pulmonary, lungs. When the blood flows through your lungs, we call that circulation as the pulmonary circulation. Here, right ventricle pumps blood to the pulmonary circulation. Then systemic circulation is passing blood to other parts of your body. Left ventricle is pumping supply blood to the aorta, or for the pulmonary circulation. Now look at this. This is the systemic circulation. Both the circulations are here. This is the systemic circulation, passing blood to other parts of your body. This is the pulmonary circulation, entering blood to your lungs. Both these circulations together known as the double circulation. Right, now we will, there's a question why the left ventricular wall is thicker than the right ventricular wall. This is the right side, this is the left side. Here, these are the ventricles. Bottom the ventricles, upper the auricles. The question is why the left ventricular wall is thicker than the right ventricular wall. Right. Here, these two vessels are entering to the left atrium. They are coming from your lungs after purification of the blood. Blood with oxygen. They enter to the left atrium. From there, it enters through the bicuspid valves or mitral valves to the left ventricle. The ventricle, the function of the ventricle is squeezing and passing blood to this systemic circulation or aorta. So the left ventricle has to exert more force for this pumping, because the blood has to travel throughout the whole body. Therefore, to withstand the pressure, the left ventricular wall is more thicker than the right ventricular wall. Next, we will discuss about the cardiac cycle. Under cardiac cycle, first we will see what is the heartbeat. The heartbeat is contraction and dilation or the relaxation of heart muscles. Heartbeat of a healthy person, heartbeat rate 72 beats per minute. And in one heartbeat, atria contracts, ventricle relax, again ventricle contracts and atria dilation or relaxation. This is, I have taken the next step, I have taken a diagram to explain what is the diastole and systole. Actually the diastole means contraction of atria, the upper two chambers. Contraction of atria is a diastole. Systole means the contraction of the ventricles, the lower two chambers. Intermediate means relaxed mode of the atria and the ventricle. Right. These two diagrams will explain you what is the diastole and the systole. Here the diastole means contraction of atria. Atria, right and left atria will contract and push blood to these ventricles. So filling in the diastole moment, filling the ventricles because of the contraction of atria. Under systole, ventricles are squeezing and pushing blood, the right ventricle to the pulmonary artery and left ventricle to the aorta. This is the systole or pumping blood. Intermeaning means relaxed mode of the atria and the ventricle. Now this is the diagram taken from the ECG, electrocardiogram. Here P is atrial contraction, or we call diastole. Q, R, S, ventricular contraction, or we call systole. T is the intervening or the resting period. This is known as the complete cardiac cycle. Now we will talk about the lub and dub sound. These are the sounds we hear when doctor keeps a stethoscope onto your chest. ECG and the lub dub sound. Here you can see the diagram taken from the electrocardiogram machine. Actually, the lub sound is longer than the dub sound. Dub sound is the shortest sound, right? Produced when bicuspid and tricuspid. Now you can recall the location of the bicuspid and tricuspid valves, or we call AV valves. When AV valves are closed, you can hear the lub sound. Dub sound is heard when closing the semilunar valves. Recall the location of the semilunar valves. They are located at the base of the pulmonary artery and the aorta. Now we are going to compare or to get the differences of the systolic blood pressure and the diastolic blood pressure. Under systolic blood pressure, contraction of ventricles and push blood through the arteries to the lungs and to the rest of the body. Contraction of ventricles. This force creates pressure on arteries. This is the systolic blood pressure, and the value is given 110 to 120 millimeters Hg. This is the measuring unit. Then under systolic blood pressure, pressure in the arteries when heart pressed between beats. The value is 70 to 80 millimeters Hg. You can go through the diagrams and understand this, what is the systole and diastole and their pressures. Blood pressure, this is the normal blood pressure, 120-80 millimeters Hg. 120 is the systolic blood pressure. It is high. 80 is the diastolic blood pressure. This is the way you mention the blood pressure of a healthy person. Reasons for high BP: aging, when you become old, the blood pressure increases, so changing, stressful mentality, due to sex and due to different diseases. These are the reasons to change the blood pressure. Finally, we will discuss about the diseases and disorders associated with the human circulatory system. First, I will take the disease atherosclerosis, or we call this as deposition of cholesterol in arteries and reducing the size of the lumen. Because of this, blood pressure increases and there can be chest pain, angina. Right. Condition low density lipoproteins. We call it as the cholesterol LDL. Low density lipoprotein. These are depositing in your coronary arteries and reduce the size of the artery, reduce the size of the hole or the lumen. Then blood supply to the heart is affected, reducing the blood supply to your heart. Malfunction of the cardiac muscles, we call that condition as angina or chest pain, and heart failure due to lack of receiving blood. And reasons to increase low density lipoprotein due to bad health habits, consumption of food containing more oils. And the remedial methods, follow good health habits and you can go for medical treatments. This is the diagram explains about the condition of atherosclerosis. Here this is the artery of a healthy person. This is the artery of a person suffering from atherosclerosis. Here you can see the deposition of low density lipoprotein and reducing the size of the lumen. Then the next disease is hypertension, or we call high blood pressure. Reason is due to the deposition of cholesterol inside the arteries and the reduction of the size of the lumen, and because of this, elasticity of the arterial wall will be reduced, and the remedial method for this, immediate medical treatments and follow good health habits. these are the symptoms occur due to high blood pressure. We go through these things. And hypotension means low BP or low blood pressure. Signs are blood pressure goes low, occurs mostly due to nutritional deficiencies. Remedial methods, immediate medical treatments to bring the blood pressure to the normal level. These are the diseases or symptoms due to low blood pressure, blurred vision, shallow breath, thirst and nausea, cold, clammy, pale skin, lack of concentration, then dizziness, palpitation and depression. Yes, there are some more symptoms of low blood pressure. Then the next disease is thrombosis, so we call this as the coronary thrombosis. Blood supply to a certain organs is affected due to a blood clot. Right, what is happening here? Formation of a blood clot and reduce the supply of blood to different parts of your body. There can be brain failures and paralysis, affect the coronary arteries, that's why we call coronary thrombosis, and finally the heart attack. Signs of deep vein thrombosis, sudden fainting, sudden rapid pulse, coughing up blood, pain in the foot and ankle, feeling lightheaded or dizziness, unexplained sudden shortness of breathing, and also pain in one leg that increases when legs are pressed. These are the symptoms of the coronary thrombosis. Then controlling of coronary thrombosis, avoiding alcohol and smoking, reduction of consumption of saturated fatty acids, or reduction of intake of more oily food, consumption of food with more dietary fibers, reduction of intake of more salt or salty food, control of diabetes, reduce the body weight, maintenance of the proper BMI, regular physical exercises, as well as having a peaceful mental status, stay happy. Right, I hope you all can understand the lesson. Have a blessed day and thank you very much.